on this house made up of regrets. Soon will blow away with the wind, but I can't let another entity in. I'm afraid I've reached full capacity. Yes, I've laid in bleach and you can't pull this face from me. Stronger green and I clean with God, like I was a dog with my tail in between my legs as it begs to be kicked out of misery. See, I'm fizzling out. Sitting, you're fitting this mitten all up on the side of your dome. A home. Coincidentally, we have somehow eventually imploded in on our love. When I sit back and think of everything that we went through and how we walked so many miles in each other's shoes, yet still I'm plagued with this feeling of losing you to something so basic and menially juvenile. I haven't had your embrace in a while. I can't help but refrain from notions of denial to the desperate point where I'm dry heaving due to the fact that you're refusing to believe me. Yet I know that you see me. Please free me from freezing in this deep freeze above your love and everything holding me down for so long. I've gone on thinking without blinking as I'm sinking fast in your sound. Who is it? I can't sit any farther down than I have sunk in your dunk in the reminiscence of what's left of what I have found. I tried to run and escape it, but the feelings I can't fake it. It was firmly forsaken. You thanked him up and around. I'm running in sleep, sprinting in cheap, jogging in my dreams, but it seems to keep sporadically lifting the scab as I'm drifting along the sandy floor of the murky seabed in my head. I'm running around all of the bends, teetering to the point where it offends my center of gravity. I can't let it be approaching a stalemate stuck until I perfectly heard the birds and bees all plotting my demise. Separated and acquainted, my best wishes have been belated. I'm glad that you waited while this tropic topic conversated itself to the top shelf, then left to accumulate wealth in hell as it froze over and under, produced a peculiar thunder. You plunder as I sit beside in a mediocre gaze, waits the dread days and the hell stays. He saves the graves that came from the rakes of the primordial tank of the cesspool of life. The tension so thick and elephant, pink cutting with the knife, spinning into this abyss, grinning as you kiss in it. Sitting, you're fitting this mitten all up on the side of your dome. You lied and told me that I made this house a home. Coincidentally, we have some power eventually imploded in our love. When I sit back and think of everything that we went through and how we walked so many miles in each other's shoes, yet still I'm plagued with this notion of losing you to something so basic that menially juvenile. I haven't had your embrace in a while. I can't help but refrain from motions of denial to the desperate point where I'm dry heaving due to the fact that you're refusing to believe me. And I know that you see me. Please free me from freezing in this deep freeze above your love and everything holding me down for so long. I've gone on thinking without blinking as I'm singing fast in your sound. You wizard, I can't sit any farther down than I have sunk in the dark in the reminiscence of what's left of what I have found. I tried to run and escape, but the feelings I can't fake it. It was firmly forsaken. You thanked him up and around. I'm running in sleep, sprinting is cheap, jogging. jogging in my dreams, but it seems to keep sporadically lifting the sky as I'm drifting along the sandy floor of the murky seabed. In my head, I'm running around all of the banks to the point that it defends my center of gravity. I cannot let it be approaching a stalemate's tone until I perfectly heard the birds and bees all plotting my demise. Separated and acquainted, my best wishes have been belated. I'm glad that you waited while this topic conversated itself to the top shelf and left to accumulate wealth in hell as it froze over and produced a peculiar thunder. You blunder as I sit to the side in a mediocre gaze, waste the dragon days in the hellish days. Who saves the graves, the cave from the lakes of the primordial tank? Get this cesspool of life, the tension's so thick an elephant can cut it with the knife.